Hello and welcome to the Simple Steps Personal Finance Podcast. Bringing personal finance to you, step by step. This is episode 12. We're going to break into our regular series of podcasts at the moment and just touch on that thing that I think you've already forgotten. New Year's resolutions. So this episode, I'm going to talk to you briefly about New Year's financial resolutions. Next time, we'll crack on with the year, and I'll continue talking about protection and critical illness cover and income protection insurance. But let's be honest, there's only really two types of resolutions: losing weight and doing better with your money. Now, I'm a bit of a permanent resident at my gym, so if you were to ask me for tips, I'd say keep a food diary to demonstrate to you yourself that you actually eat more than you think you do. Look to exercise at least 3 times a week, but preferably 4 or 5, mix in cardio and weight training, and take a photo each week to prove progress to yourself. And lastly, concentrate on building a new shape rather than just thinning down your old one. However, as I'm a financial coach, it might even be better for me to give you tips on how to fix your finances in line with those resolutions. So this year's resolutions last past the first fortnight of the year. And that's where we are. We're on the 15th, and I want to push them home so that you stick with them for the full month and then the full year. First tip. To lose weight, you'd likely join a gym. Well, my financial version of that is to open a new bank account. Most people don't like their bank. They get nothing from their account, and they have no idea how much they actually have available to spend a given moment of the month. So here's how you fix that. Get an account that you use to do only two things: receive your pay and then pay your bills. Then get another account to do only one thing: hold your spending cash. That way, you know that your obligations will be met through the first account, and exactly how much you have free to spend through the second account. You can add savings accounts and other things around the edges, but ultimately these two accounts make up your day-to-day interactions with money. And boy, will life be simpler and clearer now. Listen back to episodes 8 and 9 for more on how to do this. For the really eager amongst you, you could look at the Santander 123 current account, which pays cash back on direct debits for selected household bills. You could also look to which banks have the best customer service to have your spending cash account with them. Now, here's a hint. First Direct will pay you £100, sometimes £125, sometimes £150 to join them. And they win any poll for best customer service by a country mile. Now, as usual, there are terms and conditions for any bank account, so do your research that you will meet their ongoing requirements. Second tip. To lose weight, you'd likely start to be careful about what you eat. Well, the financial version of this would be to get back in touch with cash. Remember those bits of paper with the Queen's head on them that you used to swap for goods and services? Well, start using them again. If only just for a week or 2 weeks, the rise of plastic cards has lessened our restraint to spend money. Now, lots of independent research has been carried out, and it all says the same thing. Spending on a credit card doesn't register in the brain as spending cash. Spending on a debit card registers a bit, but not much. Whereas physically spending cash actually registers as pain. Think about it, it makes sense. Doesn't handing over a fistful of tenners cause you to wince? Sure it does, it's painful to say goodbye to that much money. But typing in your PIN doesn't hurt whatever the amount. Spend £5 with a waft of contactless pay, or £5,000 on a holiday. It's all the same to the plastic card. Oh, and another thing I heard recently gave me pause for thought. When you hand over money to get the item, it's a win-lose transaction. You win the item and lose the money. When you use a card to buy an item, though, there's no lose, as you don't physically give anything up. They hand you the card back, along with the item you've just bought. Now, there might be something in that. I don't know. What do you think? Third tip. To lose weight, you'll likely try to burn off some fat. What shape does financial cardio come in? It comes in the form of cancelling direct debits for things you no longer use. It's also closing dormant accounts and cards for stuff that is disused. It's chopping up old store cards and credit cards. Want to feel like you just lost a stone in weight? pay off your debts, close your old accounts. You'll feel so good, you'll walk an inch taller. Fourth tip, getting in shape, you'll be aiming at a target weight. Well, financially, we have to look at the end game too. This one makes all of us uncomfortable, but as adults, we have to grit our teeth and bear it. Make a will. If you've got a partner or children or dependents, or you co-own a flat or a house with someone, or you're just over 18, then make a will. You might want to say where your assets should go when you die, or you may wish to name guardians to look after your children should you and your wife suffer an accident. Don't leave it to guesswork. Get it done right. Every November, leading charities run Will Aid, where a donation to charity gets you a professionally done will. So do good by doing good. And whilst we're all being grown up, ask about doing a power of attorney at the same time. If you lose your ability to look after yourself, then you'll need someone else to have the right to do that for you. Accidents happen, people get old. Life isn't necessarily perennially rosy, so make sure that a trusted loved one can access your accounts, sign for things on your behalf, and carry the legal power to enforce your wishes. Now that document is a power of attorney, and it can be written to only come into force when your capacity is diminished, so you don't have to be panicking that it might be misused in the meantime. And at the very time when you need it, you'll have it. If you don't have one and you suddenly need one, it'll be too late to get one. So it's the ultimate precaution. Fifth tip, losing weight and building a new physique takes a plan and then patient execution of that plan. It's the same when it comes to making financial preparations. You know how expensive Christmas actually is at this time of the year. So split the cost of the festive period up into 11 chunks. From now until November, put a slice of the cost away each month and it'll be more achievable. When December next comes round and they schedule Christmas in again somewhere near the end of it, you'll be able to spend without guilt and spend without ruining your finances for that December and January. Instead, you can enjoy December, spending the money you diligently squirreled away, and you can go into the next January without a financial hangover. Now, this trick works on other things too, like saving for holidays, saving for birthdays, new curtains, you get the idea. And if you're doing the first tip too, set up fake bills that transfer money into a savings account each month, automatic savings, and no fear that you're going to spend the money instead. Sixth tip, once you hit your target weight, you'll give yourself a reward. So what's the financial version of that chocolate donut or Big Mac meal? How does a cash injection sound? Well, every December, I have an early spring clean and sell unused items on eBay, Amazon, or to people I know. They might be last year's unused gifts or purchases that I made that I no longer remember the initial reason I bought them for. Might be outdated stuff that I've since upgraded from. Whatever it is, I get to clear the house out, let someone else get a bargain, and get some cash in my pocket for my efforts. One man's trash is another man's treasure, and December is the best time to cash in as people seek to fill their chests with gold. Seventh tip. If you got this far, you must be serious, so good luck. Well, that's not a tip, is it? Okay, so how's this sound instead? Don't go too hard on yourself too quickly. The old saying is, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. So just put one foot in front of the other and the rest will take care of itself. This time next year, you can be thin and rich. You just have to get that person you see in the mirror each morning to behave themselves. See you next week for a regular podcast. Until then, Happy New Year.